You know what he told me before the game? He said, please tell the people out there, I welcome the challenge to play anybody home and away. That's Kentucky, Kansas, Indiana, Michigan State. Bring them all down. We'll go to their place home and away.
You're in our programming department now all of a sudden. Here's the starting lineup, and all of these guys back from last year, including Anderson, the sophomore, putting up big rebounding and assist numbers for the Duke Blue Devils. Parker and Hood combine for almost 41 points per game, and Quinn Cook is among national leaders in assists per game. Duke is the home team. They're in white. UCLA is in blue. The first time they've met in 11 years. Carl Hesse, Corbett, and Michael Stevens are officials, and we're underway here in New York.
I think a key player tonight, Quinn Cook. I think his abilities got better and better. His numbers have gotten better.
Here's Parker. He's being defended in the early going by Travis Ware. Both twins in the starting lineup for the Bruins. Tyler Thornton with a shot fake. Floater from the baseline, not there. And here come the Bruins with their first possession. Ooh, and an elbow as Thornton got caught by an inadvertent elbow from David Ware. And Travis Ware slams it home at the other end.
Thornton's going to be guarded by Anderson. They feel that Anderson can zone a little bit out there. Thornton not a threat offensively.
Well, Kyle Anderson is the one offensively, but he doesn't cover point guards. Here is the elbow right there that caught Thornton in the side of the head. It was not observed. And meanwhile, at the other end, Anderson lobs it up in the easy finish for Travis Ware.
People are going to really appreciate the artistic ability of Anderson in passing the basketball. He's so creative.
And now the officials are going to review and look at this elbow and decide whether it was a, quote, basketball play or whether it's something that should be penalized.
I don't think he did it deliberately. I really don't. I don't think that was deliberate. I think bottom line is he didn't even know he was back there. He's turning. He might have felt a little weight.
Carl Hess calling over Ed Corbett to have a look at it.
Can't use the monitor to determine whether or not a flagrant took place. What do you think, boss? You think that? I thought it was really not. I thought it was inadvertent. I really did. I didn't think it was any deliberate intention there.
And it looks like no penalty is going to be assessed, so they agree with you.
I agree with
here
you.
Here we go. Yeah.
I don't think it was done with intent.
So UCLA with the first basket of the game on the alley-oop, and here come the Blue Devils, their second possession.
Well, the big key right now, UCLA defensively, will work in violation out of control. That is the major concern of Steve Alford. Told me before the game, he said, we have to rebound and defend if we're going to be an elite team.
Travis Ware is the guy who was playing defense and caused that travel. He's grimacing a little bit. Remember, he's coming back from an appendectomy several weeks ago. Don't know if it's related, as Hood ran into him. And we'll keep an eye on that. Ware missed the first three games of the season after going an appendectomy. Nice ball movement by the Blue Devils in the lane for Hood.
Nice play right there. Good ball reversal. Great angle to get the ball inside the hood.
And look at UCLA trying to run as Powell draws the foul on Hairston. UCLA wants to get out and go, Dick, whenever they can.
They really can. Good at transition. They haven't really played a great schedule. I think anybody can look at their schedule, and you can know that this is a special game for them. They had that one tough journey, went to Missouri,
yep,
and they got it out.
They were leading at halftime, got outscored badly in the second half. Norman and Powell at the line for the Bruins. He seems much more comfortable this year, understands his role. His numbers are up. He's shooting 60% from the field. He's scoring better than 12 points per game. And he's one of a number of Bruins who have seemingly taken their play to the next level. He's a junior out of San Diego. And it looks like it's going to be interesting in the Pac-12. Arizona's obviously got a great team, but you put in UCLA, Oregon, going to be a competitive league.
Oregon, very good. They got a really deep backcourt. They just got Dominic Hardis back in their rotation. Dana Altman's done a good job with that club.
Colorado going to make some noise, too.
Yeah, tough. Tad Boyle's done a fantastic job. Tough, especially at home. Stas, Kansas.
Hood for three. Hairston tries to tap it back out, and Duke winds up with possession. Jabari Parker for three.
Star, my friends. That's a star. He is absolutely a superstar. If you talk about best player in the nation, you better include in the argument Jabari Parker.
22 points per game for the freshman. Jordan Adams, talk about big scoring numbers. He's at better than 21 a game. This is that shot, and it's Duke ball. There has been a really no drop-off. He had one 15-point game. That's the lowest scoring game that he's had so far this year.
I tell you, we had Duke and Michigan, and they played terrific in that game. I think Michigan's a quality basketball team. It will be very good when you get in a conference play. And in that game, Duke did a tremendous job defensively.
Yep. They picked it up a notch defensively since that Vermont game a few weeks back. Parker with the drive and the basket.
I thought he might have got away with a walk there. Prior to taking that ball to the goal, I thought he took an extra step. But he showed his versatility. You're going to watch this right here. Take a look right here. I don't know. Close, very close.
He is such a tough cover. He can shoot the three, he can drive, and how many teams have a guy his size and with the athleticism to defend him inside and outside?
And he's just a terrific kid, yeah, away from basketball. All the guys like Grant Hill, Matty A, Jason, Jay Williams, our guy. Something about those kids, they're more than basketball players.
Six early points for Parker. Anderson, nice look. Travis Ware, short on the three.
Great look by Anderson again, showing his ability to always find the open man, but they got to convert. Yep.
Anderson is 6'9", didn't really play that much point last year. They had Larry Drew the second, but now he is the undisputed point guard for the UCLA Bruins. Boy, Parker is really feeling confident in the early going. Missed that three.
He shot that from the NBA three-point line.
And here's Adams fouling on a drive.
I think a guy that people are going to love coming off the bench for UCLA, Levine. Remember that name, Levine.
Zach Levine, will see him. He's actually their second leading scorer behind Adams. And how good has this guy been? As you look at Levine on the bench, Adams better than 21 points per game, gets to the free throw line like crazy, almost eight times a game, and knocks them down at an 86% clip.
You know, everybody last year was excited about the combo of Anderson and Muhammad, but for some reason they could never seem to get into that flow and do what a lot of the experts projected.
Wound up costing Ben Howland his job. Three final four trips in a row, 06, 07, 08. Last year actually won the Pac-12 regular season title. Lost in their first game, what's now called the second round of the NCAA tournament. Ben Howland let go. Steve Alford comes in from New Mexico. Thornton with a look into the corner. For three.
He's been a big player for them. He's gotten better and better distributing the basketball. Ben Howland, I can't say enough about what he did to go three straight years to a Final Four. Usually they build a monument, but at UCLA, it's national championships, man.
Travis Ware, 12-footer from the baseline, in and out. They're down with a strong rebound. Josh Hairston, as Mike Krzyzewski continues to start Hairston and Thornton, experienced players and good blue guy defensive players as well.
Yeah, he really goes on it for the defensive edge right there, bringing those two on the floor. And then he counts out offensively the threesome of Hood, Parker.
What a feed from Cook to Hairston.
I'm telling you, he's getting better and better, the point guard. He's becoming a star point guard in the ACC.
David Ware knocks down the three.
Getting open looks from the perimeter. You're going to have to make those open shots.
Very experienced guys. Fifth-year seniors, 23 years of age. David and Travis Ware. Of course, they started at Carolina, so the Duke program familiar with them.
Yep, started at North Carolina. You get enough PT playing time going back to California. See, this has been the problem for UCLA. Really having a tough time defending. Didn't have much trouble in some of the games because it was Cupcake City.
Boy, he's special too.
I can see what Steve Alford's talking about. You can't give open looks like that, Dan.
Ooh. Slipping is Hairston. Missing is Adams. And it's out of bounds to Duke as we go to the first media timeout of the game.
Too many easy shots. They get too many open looks, Duke. You're going to take a look at Jabari Parker, showing his range. There's the trifecta, and then he
wound up resulting in the first championship for John Wooden.
Yeah, that was the special John Wooden team. Unbelievable. They, Mr. Hazard had a great deal. Look at Coach Wooden, the Wizard of Westwood.
Well, Steve Alford told Andy Katz before the game his two concerns were defense and rebounding. They've let Duke shoot 6 out of 9 in the early going. There's a good rejection. And they're being out rebounded now 8-2. So Steve Alford, what he was worried about, is coming true here early.
That 4-1 ratio right there on the rebounding end. 6 for 9 and be getting open looks.
Emile Jefferson, Andre Dawkins in for Duke. That's Dawkins, who's been lights out lately, shooting the ball well, getting back to being more like the player he was before the redshirt year, and he's getting more and more minutes.
Well, he's earning playing time. He's really played a lot more in the last 2 games. 6 for 9 in those last 2 games, shooting the 3.
Spin by Anderson, good ball movement by the Bruins. Travis Ware, short on the 3. His brother David comes up with it. And it's out of bounds, I think, to UCLA. And it will be Bruins ball. And here come the subs for the Bruins right now. Tony Parker, Zach LaVine, and there's Bryce Alford, the son of Coach Steve. He was headed to New Mexico to play for his dad until Steve took the job at UCLA. And not surprisingly, the kid's got a pretty good shot.
He's a good shooter, number one, just like his dad. Yep. He can shoot the rock. And number two, his assist to turnover ratio is 3-1.
Look at Adams. Everything but the finish for Jordan Adams.
He did a terrific job getting to the basket, but as you said, didn't finalize. See, defense is played as a unit. Look at his zone right now. He's going out of the man-to-man.
And Alford and LaVine up at the top of that zone. They're real good energy guys off the bench for UCLA as well. Who wins the battle? It's Bruins ball.
There's another example right there in that zone. Had a big gap in seam, and Parker got himself an easy shot. Just didn't convert. Steve Alford, man, he can shoot the ball. Play for the General Robert Montgomery Knight. Who could ever forget national title 1987?
He was an All-American. He was an Olympian, too. Off-balance shot. And UCLA's getting the ball up on the rim, but nothing's dropping for them right now.
Not getting any second or third opportunities. You got to find Dawkins immediately. His eyes should light up against the zone. He should find a gap and seam in that zone and step in. He can shoot the 3.
Jabari Parker being defended by Tony Parker. No relation between the two. The two big guys on the inside. Now Jabari Parker with the screen. Shot clock is down to 7. Dawkins beyond the NBA line for 3.
No doubt about it, man. When he lets it go, you have a feeling it's going to go in. There aren't many guys that you have that feeling. I had it when that guy used to shoot it, Mr. Alford. When Chris Mullin used to shoot it, Reggie Miller, Tracy Murray, who's here tonight, doing the radio broadcast from UCLA.
You know, at practice today, Steve Wojciechowski, as he always does, says, hey, guys, pro arena. The blue line is the college line. The white's the NBA. But Dawkins didn't care on that attempt. He was deep beyond the white line. There's Anderson with a drive and a finish.
He seemed more into the flow this year. You can feel it. I thought last year mentally he was struggling, trying to really get a feel for what they wanted him to do. He's a sophomore, played for Bob Hurley. He'll be here tonight. He's coming from practice. Just talked to his wife.
Yeah, Anderson's a New Jersey guy. Has only played in this building once before. That's when he was on an AAU team when he was 11 years old. He played at halftime of a Knicks game. That's the only other time he's ever played in this building.
And I'll guarantee he was probably the star of the game.
Probably.
You see kids like that are stars very early.
Let's check in with Andy.
Well, a year ago when Kyle Anderson got to UCLA, Larry Drew II was the point guard and more of a true point guard. With the coaching change, the timing was perfect for Anderson to now play for Steve Alford. And Alford told me earlier today that he thinks he can really take advantage of that size at 6'8", a really unique position for the Bruins.
Dawkins misses the 3. He was wide open for several seconds. Jefferson didn't see him and eventually cooked on him the ball, but he missed the shot. And there's Anderson fouled on the drive to take us to a timeout.
He really goes at his own pace. He's improved his range as a shooter, 6 for 9, shooting 3s.
But he had a pretty good handle today.
There aren't many guys that have his handle. This kid is really headed for a big Super South year.
The last guy to average the point, rebounding, and assist totals that Anderson is averaging now was Evan Turner 4 years ago at Ohio State.
Switch on the defensive end. Anderson being guarded right now by Dawkins.
Alford driving on. Nice pass inside to Adams.
There's that unselfishness of Alford. He's more than just a shooter. He can pass the ball and to stay in that zone. There are a lot of big gaps in that zone in the foul line area.
And again, the bench, the tandem of Alford and Levine, they've been terrific. Making plays, giving UCLA a lot of energy, and often the so-called second unit plays just as well as the first unit for UCLA. Adams called for the carry.
He said, what do you mean, carry? We're in Madison Square Garden. It's the NBA. You get away with that. He definitely carried. That's a look at Bryce. Right now, Alford. Great look, knew where his teammate was. Bad job defensively by Duke. No communication. That's a no-no. You play for Duke, you better communicate. They did not communicate defensively.
And that's been something Mike Krzyzewski has been harping on this year, is no matter how hard you're working, if you don't communicate, you can't play good D.
You know, a lot of guys go to a 2-3 zone, and their mentality, they're saying what we're trying to do is hide some deficiencies defensively.
The three rattles out on Cook, and it's Bruins ball.
See, I think some people become very guilty when they see a 2-3. They think they have to play exclusively on the perimeter. That's what Duke's been doing.
Anderson shooting the ball much better this year as well. He is now 10 for 16 from three-point range on the season.
He was shooting 60% coming this game. There's the lob, bring it inside. Diagonal. You don't have to attack the zone just from the perimeter. You can bring it inside, then go outside.
And Jabari Parker off to a big start here tonight, now with eight. Another great feed, this time from Anderson to Adams.
I don't want people to think I'm saying he's Magic Johnson. He's nowhere near. But he has that kind of passing ability. 6'9", yep. Size, handle it, great vision and feel. That's what Magic had when he played at Michigan State with the Lakers.
Ball still loose. Finally tied up, and it's going to go over to UCLA.
And I want to make it very clear, Mr. Schulman.
I understand.
Very clear.
I understand.
I am not saying he is Magic Johnson, because he is not. But let me tell you, look at this, wide open. Throw the ball over the top of the zone, layup. Can't give those kind of easy layups.
Cook averaging 6.6 assists per game, and you know a lot of those have gone to Parker. So Alford now the primary point guard. When he comes in, Anderson plays off the ball, can play the three or the four. Tony Parker the miss and the rebound to Rodney Hood.
Tony Parker's going to catch that ball, have himself a layup.
Tough pass, too much traffic. Third turnover committed by Duke. Adams. And it's a blocking foul on Hood.
What I like about Anderson, he's always looking ahead, trying to make that pass, always looking ahead.
Number two, Dick, on Rodney Hood, and Rashid Suleiman is going to come into the game. Hood will have to sit down, and Suleiman, who's gone from a guy, a starter, double-digit scorer, a guy talked about as a first-round pick in the NBA last year, he didn't play a minute against Michigan. He only played five against Gardner-Webb, and he's going to have to work his way back into regular minutes right now for Duke.
You know, I spoke to Mike before the game, and we spoke about Rashid. He said he's starting to see some signs of him playing a lot better in the practice environment. Had not played well in practice and lost his playing time.
Andy Katz says more.
Yeah, that's right. When we were talking to Coach K earlier during the shoot-around, it was not any kind of discipline. It was more than anything that he just was not practicing and playing well. And Coach K said, you remember this, Dan, there's 200 minutes in a game. And you know three guys, Quinn Cook, Jabari Parker, and Rodney Hood are going to get most of the minutes. And so Rashid's got to find his minutes within that.
Marshall Plumlee called for the travel. Yeah, Coach K said three guys get about 100. That leaves about 100 minutes for everybody else, and the guys who are playing to get best are going to get the minutes, and Dawkins is playing better, and Matt Jones has given them a spark, and Suleiman's got a battle for minutes right now.
Tell you one thing, you guys have become a mathematical genius. You got to go to Harvard to be able to sit next to you and Katz. I mean, this math is blowing me out of my mind.
It wasn't actually that complicated, my friend. Howell makes it a one-point game.
That's a big-time drive right there. Very athletic. The one thing about this UCLA team, Steve Alford's taking advantage of their athleticism and utilizing them properly to play in transition.
They are not ranked right now, looking for that first signature win and hoping tonight's the night. Suleiman knocks down a three.
That'll get you some playing time. Start making some shots like he did last year. There were many a game last year where he was a difference maker.
Averaged almost 12 points per game as a freshman. Anderson defended by Parker. cradles in, left hand up and over Parker.
What a terrific play by Anderson. They played against each other in high school in an AAU travel game. They were down 26, Anderson's team, and came back and won. I read it today in an article by Zach Brazella of the New York Post. Yeah. See, I steal that information.
You ever seen a guy who starts at the point, and then when the backup point guard comes in, they move him to the power forward spot, to the four? I mean, he's a unique blend of talent.
Tell you one thing, Bryce Wolford has given him a lift off the bench.
He launches. He hits.
What a lift he's given him.
And look at the emotion. Look at the enthusiasm on Bryce Wolford as UCLA has the lead.
And his granddaddy jumped out of his seat down in Indiana. This is a good UCLA basketball team. Very talented. Athletic, talented. They just make a commitment to defense. They're going to have a really strong year.
Nice pass. Tony Parker misses the mid-range jumper. Thornton. Quick shots at both ends right now.
Well, that's really not one of their strengths right there, shooting the three for Thornton.
Anderson, no.
Playing tonight in front of Bob Hurley, one of the greatest coaches of all time in the Hall of Fame on the high school level at St. Anthony's. And a hug and kiss from Bob Hurley's wife.
Suleiman in and out. Parker keeping it alive, but it's Bruins ball. Nice look ahead to Zach LaVine.
Oh, showtime. What a look. Did you see that pass? That feel? That feel? I used to see that all the time in L.A. It was for Magic, the Worthy. It was showtime. Look at a great look. Yeah, everybody raved about his athleticism tonight before the game, and there's the reason why. Can't teach that, my friend. Mm-mm. Can't teach that.
He's 6'5". He kind of grew late. He's really got point guard skills. He was kind of small in high school. He committed to UCLA, and when Ben Hallen was fired and Steve Alford took over, he decided to honor the commitment, and aren't the Bruins glad he did. Almost 14 a game off the bench. Cook. Duke needed that.
He's so solid, handles the ball well, plays on the defensive end. Last year had great moments at the end of the year, started to slip a little bit.
Powell, bounce pass inside. Ware has it rejected.
Cook leads them in minutes play, plays 35 minutes a game. He's a valuable player in that Duke team.
Suleiman. And ripping down the rebound is Travis Ware. Tons of outside shots from Duke tonight ever since UCLA went to that zone.
Yeah, really not patient enough. I don't think he showed enough patience against that zone.
No Jabari Parker in the game right now for Duke. No Kyle Anderson for UCLA. We are in a break zone, so both coaches getting them a little bit of rest right now.
Trying to get some good spacing offensively. UCLA's going to score points this year. There's no doubt about it.
How about LaVine from outside this time?
You talk about versatility. We saw him on the jam and transition, and now we see him shooting the trifecta.
LaVine came into the game 46% from beyond the arc. Alford and LaVine up at the top of that zone. That's where they've been since they checked in. Thornton's open for three.
Don't let him shoot it, Dan. They're going to let them shoot him from the perimeter, especially guys like Thornton in it. I don't think Mike Krzyzewski can be happy with their offensive execution.
Alford, again!
Just like Daddy, man. He said, Daddy, I learned from you. I learned from you how to shoot the rock.
And that guy right there, his dad was one of the great shooters we have seen in college basketball.
I tell you, he was really perfect for that system, Bob Knight. The passing games, to get him off those screens.
Suleiman. Tip back up and in by Hairston.
They needed that tip. Duke is going exclusively with the jump shot from the perimeter.
The Blue Devils have taken 12 two-pointers and 15 three-pointers as the Bruins turn it over.
Kyle Anderson right down the interior. There is the little floater, left hand, and then Bryce Drew comes off the bench. Catches it, squares his body like his daddy, and it's nothing but nylon. And there's Mr. LaVine, Jam City. Oh, I'm going to love him in Tinseltown.
The hair wasn't much different, and the jump shot was awfully sweet.
Tell you one thing, I did many of their games, and it was really sweet watching him play. Played on those outstanding Bob Knight teams down in Indiana. Bob Knight's had a real big influence in his game. Mike Krzyzewski and Steve Alford.
Powell is back into the game. Alford, who hit a couple of threes, has gone to the bench.
There's that 2-3 zone. Got to try to attack in the gaps of it.
Anderson with a steal. Powell knocked away by Cook. Great defensive play by Quinn Cook.
He really did make a play because they did the right thing, trying to drive the bounce pass for the layup.
Jabari Parker back into the game for Duke. He leads them with 8.
See the open area right behind the foul line, wide open. I mean, it is wide open in that area. Slide somebody to the high post area. Use him as a zigzag man.
Parker for 3.
That area is wide open. Right about a foul line area.
Boy, when they need a basket, how often is he the guy to make a play?
Well, that's the guy you want to go to. That's why he's the star of stars.
Into double figures now with 11. Duke back within 1. Turnaround by Powell. Tip back up, and on the second opportunity, it's David Ware who gets the basket.
Better job rebounding now by UCLA. Started off really sluggish. They were being out rebounded 10-2, but right now, they've really cut that gap.
Well, they got a lot of size in this zone, too. Levine and Powell up top, and the Wares and Anderson down on the baseline.
And it also eliminates your fouling.
Offensive rebound, Emile Jefferson. Can't convert.
Not a good shot right there by Jefferson.
Travis Ware. And Parker, good box out for the rebound.
Great inside position rebounder right there by Jabari Parker. He's a coach's dream, man. You dream. I know Tommy's own came so close, but getting second and coming close doesn't count with Rudy.
Again, almost everything for Duke right now coming from the perimeter ever since UCLA went to the zone.
You have no post presence at all. None.
Using a lot of clock again, searching for a good look. Cook finds Jefferson, and he lays it in with a reverse.
Nice play by Cook to get into the seam of the zone, find the open man, and use the baseline.
And Anderson is fouled.
Jefferson's girlfriend lives about a block away from me.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah. Miss Green. I know her daddy really well, David, and mom, Lisa. Great people.
Here, a good one. UCLA and Duke, a one-point lead for the Bruins. Look at this shot. Boy, that is a quick trigger by Zach LaVine in the corner, but now Duke comes back looking for the lead.
Hey, another thing Cook does, shoots free throws really well. He's got 23 in a row. See, right there in that foul line. And then kick it inside, outside.
The looks have been pretty clean from beyond the arc, but Duke is now 6-for-18 shooting threes. Turnover. Parker ahead to Hood.
That's Jam City, one of the best tandems in basketball. Parker and Hood converting off the turnover.
Just the 4th turnover of the game for UCLA, but that one cost them.
I tell you one thing this zone has done for UCLA, not allowed Duke to go to the free throw line. They only got 1 free throw attempt here. That zone takes away all those fouls. We had that one game in Kentucky, Carolina, 88 free throws.
David Ware for 3.
They got guys that can shoot the rock, man. They got guys that shoot the rock.
UCLA is 6-of-9 shooting threes in this game.
See the zone? They're not fouling out of that zone.
No Dawkins in the game right now. Hit a 3 earlier, then missed his next 3 attempts. Cook with the penetration. Forces it up, and here come the Bruins looking to push.
Watch the vision. And they stripped him.
Cook got him from behind.
That's the second time he's turned it over.
And Jefferson ties it up.
And the Grange come out of their seat in Lakewood Ranch, Florida. It's Andre Gaw. Jefferson, one of those guys that has to contribute coming off the bench because Duke needs size. He's turned it over. There it is right there. They're going to watch him strip him from behind. And they create an opportunity right here. Jefferson, good athleticism.
So back-to-back turnovers costing UCLA. Meanwhile, Kyle Anderson filling up the stat sheet, as he often does. 7 points, 5 rebounds, 5 assists, 3 steals, and look at this drive.
He looks like a football player. He looks like a UCLA Bruin with the football player tucked in, using the left hand with the floater. He's got the great size. Now watch the pass now. He's got already in his mind what he's going to do. That was reminiscent of Irvin Magic Johnson. I don't want to keep coming back to that, but there aren't many guys at 6'9 that can handle the ball like this guy can.
Anderson now with 6 rebounds to go with the 7 points, 5 assists, 3 steals. Shot clock is off. UCLA hoping for a good final look at Bryce Alford, who's knocked down 2 threes already, is back in the game.
I really believe you can't put enough emphasis on a key that UCLA not fouling, giving Duke an opportunity at that free throw line.
Seven seconds. Powell. And he is fouled. Duke had a foul to give. So no 1-1.
Smart play right there. Not going to go to a free throw line. That's beat cerebral, but you expect that to go to Duke. 1,500 on the SATs. I took him 3 times and had 15-20.
4 seconds as they inbound. Adams forces it up. And a very entertaining first half comes to a close with 2 awfully good teams in a dead heat.
Yeah, really, 2 teams going at it. The zone defense, I thought, was the equalizer and really gave them an edge, UCLA.
Andy Katz is standing by with Duke's associate head coach, Steve Wojciechowski.
All right, thank you, Dan. Steve, what flustered you guys the most against that zone?
Well, they're very long, and they're very good in it. We did not do a good job of penetrating the zone, either with the pass or the dribble. We have to try to get it into the paint before we are taking our outside shots. I thought we settled a little too much against it.
And defensively, how can you challenge those shooters a little bit more?
Well, we got to get back in transition. I mean, this is probably the best transition team we've played, and they're a dangerous offensive team. I thought we picked it up in the last few minutes of the half, but they're really good. And we have to play an outstanding second half to win.
All right, thanks, Steve.
Thank you.
Back to you, Dan.
All right, Andy, thank you. Tied at 37, halfway through here. Watch, and both Kyle Anderson and Jabari Parker, Wooden Award candidates. Anderson's had a triple-double this year, might get another one here tonight. And Jabari Parker on his way to another typically big evening for the Blue Devils.
I think one of the keys to whether or not Duke can solve that zone, I think Coach Steve said it best, Wojo, about the fact you got to get in the gaps, the seams, and the 3-second area. They were really becoming nothing but a perimeter shooting team.
They took 18. This is the 19th, but Parker knocks it down. It's his 3rd three of the game, and he's got a game-high 14.
Well, you know, when he takes one, they're usually in the rhythm of the offense, and once he squares his body and gets that good look, he's a good shooter.
Powell misses the jumper. Tacked back out by David Ware, but it's Rodney Hood.
Hood's been quiet in this game.
Cook steps in, unguarded, knocks it down.
Unguarded, nobody even around him. Again, one of the big concerns at UCLA, we have to be a stronger defensive team.
UCLA is not ranked. They're just outside the top 25. They're 9-1. Their lone loss was on the road at Missouri. Got outscored by 17 in the second half. Lost by 9. The 3 for David Ware. Duke is 8-2, and their 2 losses have come to Kansas and Arizona.
Tell you one thing, they're going to drive a lot of teams absolutely bananas, UCLA, with their offensive firepower. Yep.
Circle January the 9th on your calendar, the only regular season meeting between Arizona and UCLA, and it's at Pauley Pavilion.
Last year, they were 3-0 against Arizona. Ben Holland won all 3 matchups.
And Anderson eventually called for the travel. That'll be his 3rd turnover as we check in with Andy Katz.
And right before the start of the second half, I spoke with Steve Alford and asked him, why was this zone so effective? He says, look, Duke took 18 threes, as we just saw. They took their 19th and made it. And he says, we'll take our chances because they only made 6. And more importantly, he said, the zone kept them off the free throw line, just like Dick mentioned, only 1 of 1 at the line. By the way, David Ware, right before they went on the court, says the first 5 minutes, guys, first 5 minutes.
Hood. Full turnaround. And into the UCLA ball.
You know, they went to the man-to-man. You talked a little bit earlier about the fact they have not been ranked. One of the reasons, look at their schedule. I mean, you talk about Cupcake City, playing the likes of Chattanooga, Santa Barbara, playing Prairie View, playing Oakland, playing Sacramento State, Moorhead. That's not going to get you ranked, and it's not going to get your fans in the arena. Not at L.A. You're not going to fool those people. They're used to greatness out there. That's why they're averaging 5,900 fans. That is humiliating for a school with the tradition of what the Wizard of Westwood did at UCLA.
Best wins this year have been the likes of Drexel, Northwestern, UC Santa Barbara.
But you're UCLA, you got to beat those clubs. You got to beat those teams. I mean, those four letters stand for greatness. Think about the greats that have worn that uniform. Our own, the redhead, Big Bill Walton. Think about Kareem. They'll get better than those two guys.
Man-to-man by Duke. Anderson. David Ware. Another one, second three and a half for David Ware.
You know, seems like a simple play there, but he knew where he was going with that pass, Anderson, before it even happened.
Assist number six for Kyle Anderson.
Yeah, his former high school coach, very happy, took them at halftime. Bob Hurley from St. Anthony's. It's always great when you see one of your kids do well, coming back home.
And the foul is on UCLA's Jordan Adams.
This is just a feel and a flow for the game. There's the screen, steps right back from the screen, wide open, and get at the ball, and he converts.
Dick, he's made all four of his threes, and UCLA is 8 for 12 as a team.
That's big. When you're making threes at that ratio, that puts you right there, chance to win.
That's one of the big differences in the game. As you can see, UCLA making 67%, Duke 35% from beyond the arc.
To me, this is a bigger game to UCLA than Duke. Because they need that one identifying win.
A chance for a three-point play for Tyler Thornton.
The one thing is, they're not going to want to leave this building. View UCLA have a moral victories. We don't want to hear we play too tough. We want to get a W.
Second foul on Adams. They've both come in the last 10 seconds or so. There's Thornton just kind of sneaking behind the defense on the baseline.
Nice pass, though. Great diagonal look. Look at the size difference right here. Cook playing Anderson.
Cook 6'2", Anderson 6'9".
Anderson also has the ability to go inside and post it.
Powell tries to find him, but it's turned over. Hood with a drive, and he is fouled. Before the shot, no basket.
Good call. Good call. It would have been a travesty if he allowed that. I know Mike's thinking maybe he should allow it. No, he got fouled playing.
Second on Travis Ware. Yeah, very good call.
He's got great athleticism. You know, we talk about athleticism all the time. I'll define it. We're talking about lateral quickness, up and down quickness, jumping ability, first steps. We're talking about kids with athleticism.
And another UCLA foul. As we remind you that Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers continues Saturday on ESPN at noon from one of the game's great venues. Allen Fieldhouse at Lawrence as Kansas hosts Georgetown, a game you can also see live on Watch ESPN.
Fantastic article today by Nicole Arnack about scheduling, all about Georgetown, basically, and about how teams are scheduling tougher competition.
Hood is denied, and back come the Bruins with numbers. Adams.
He's been quiet. Adams been quiet. He's a big-time scorer.
He's got six, averages 21.
Oh, you got to convert that. He did a terrific play.
Anderson in to David Ware, and he's having some kind of a night. 16 points already. That is one shy of his career high.
He really is having a great night, but if I were him, I'd go right now tonight after this game and take Anderson out for dinner at a beautiful Italian restaurant. Go to Becco's, man. Great Italian restaurant.
Seven assists now for Anderson. Another Duke turnover. Anderson too far this time, trying to find Travis Ware.
A kid like Anderson, because he has that flair, that unbelievable passing ability, he's going to make mistakes because he's always trying to make the spectacular play.
That's the fourth turnover. And now Parker turns it over. Adams ahead to Anderson, and he lost it.
That's the third time he's lost the ball. And they've come back and scored three times on his turnovers. Live ball turnovers created the offense. Really is a nightmare for a coach.
What a pace to this game. Powell too strong. Cook. And he is fouled by Anderson.
I'm glad you mentioned the word pace. that was really some of the complaints. People said, well, UCLA, Steve Alford, it's not going to run. In fact, even Andy Enfield said that to Southern Cal. Andy, sorry to tell you, Steve Alford's running, baby. They're running.
Here's the Anderson turnover. Quinn Cook's running as well. He's on his way to a big night. And the Blue Devils are up by two.
Outstanding. Getting better and better.
Oh, Bruce is in the house.
Wow.
This is a big game, Biggie.
Yeah, I can see it's a big game.
You want to go get his autograph? Come
I
back
go
after
get
the
his
next time,
what about the hat he's wearing?
The zone by UCLA. Levine and Alford into the game off the bench again for the Bruins.
They started out man-to-man the second half with that zone. See, went inside, outside. See, good things happen. Good things happen. Went into the 3-second area, which we talked about in the first half, and attacking the zone, a little bit more patience, and they got the good perimeter shot.
And the lead has grown to 5. It was tied at the half. Alford and Levine both gave UCLA a spark off the bench in the first half. Alford, not this time. He made a couple of threes in the first half.
I think teams have to be a little bit more patient, understand shot selection.
And Parker fouled before the shot.
See, he goes inside, then they bring the ball. Watch this. Right into the gut of the defense. Jefferson back out the hook. Two-man game. Wow, he loves
it. Bruce is rooting for Duke.
Yeah, it looks that way. I don't like that hat he's wearing, though. Get that hat off him. Come on.
So give him a raise hat.
Get a raise hat, man. Yankees get their elves buried in the cans, but you know what the first center guy?
Beltran.
Joe Maddon. They're going to win down there in Tampa.
They get it inside again, kick it out again, but Cook misses this time.
Shooting from the NBA three. You got to know the recognition of the line. The idea is to get an easier shot. Not try to prove to people you can shoot the NBA three.
Adams from the elbow.
Just a matter of time. Score has been very quiet.
8 on the night, averaging 21. Suleiman back in the game for Duke. He hit his first shot when he came in, hit a three. Trying to earn his way back into the regular rotation. Parker from the corner for three, the assist to Suleiman.
Tell you one thing, when he shoots it, great rotation, and he squares that body so well. Really fundamental, tucks the elbow in, elevates on his shot. I got a feeling Bruce rocked this place a few times.
Levine, no, and Parker rips down the rebound.
He's a man. Jabari Parker's a man. I'm telling you right now, if you had to vote for player of the year right now, we've got a long way to go. Parker and Smart are right there.
Not this time on the lob, but Jefferson there for the follow.
See, I think Jefferson is that guy that can step up and give it a positive minutes, but I love it now. The Dukies love it right here.
Largest lead of the game, and it belongs to Duke. Yeah. Tell us what you like about him, Dick.
Well, what don't you like about him? There he is, squaring his body. I love the way he gets the great rotation on his shot. Just a terrific all-around talent.
By the way, Bruce Springsteen's daughter attends Duke. One of the reasons why. Jessica's her name. One of the reasons why the boss is here. When Cook has it knocked away. Suleiman the Hunger!
Oh, that's why I like him. That Dumpin' Dandy special. He's dancing with John. Even Bruce loves it. I think Mike Krzyzewski has a chance to get free tickets to a Springsteen concert.
Adams with a tough drive. A badly needed bucket there by UCLA.
See, right now, they're going to get some stops. UCLA defense has been really difficult for them.
By the way, Quinn Cook has 7 steals in this game, and Duke's turned a lot of that into offense. Much better ball movement against the zone in this half.
Better shots, not rushing it, a little patience. That brings a little spark on a defensive end as well.
It's a pro-Duke crowd. So many Duke alums up in the New York, New Jersey area, and they're making some serious noise right now.
I think we're starting to get a little danger time for UCLA.
Zach Levine.
There are times in this game that both clubs are very impatient. First pass, shot. Not enough touches. See, that's the difference they've done here in the half. Bringing the ball into the gut of the defense, and they're going inside outside.
They're getting better looks from the outside, and they're also getting better looks on the inside, Dickie B.
Yeah, especially finding this guy as a trailer. Oh, what a talent. There it is, Jam City, up, up, and away. Oh, is he terrific. Look at that pass. Great little look. When the ball goes to the interior, which we've been talking about, watch this right here. Now look at this, the ball goes, watch, five guys collapse to the basketball. Well, if you're patient, you kick it back out, you got wide open looks. And Hood has been a factor here in the second half. Patience equals points.
And look at the field goal percentage, 60% for Duke in the second half, including 4-for-7 from three after they went 6-for-18 from three in the first half.
Kid Murphy from Duke transferred to Florida. Going to be with the Gators.
Yeah, Alex Murphy went to play where his brother Eric played. Emile Jefferson at the line for Duke. 7 points, 5 rebounds off the bench. He had 10 rebounds in 12 minutes Monday against Gardner-Webb. And I know you've always felt Jefferson and Dawkins, two huge keys for the Blue Devils this year.
Yeah, really, they got the one consistent factor. You know about the big three. He's talking about Cook, Hood, and certainly Parker. In fact, the three of them right now got 41 of their points. But you got to get those other people to contribute. And remember, the standard for Duke isn't to get to the NCAA tournament. They have one standard. Cut the next down and be a national champ.
Which they've done four times under Mike Krzyzewski. 11 Final Fours. Levine, bounce pass in traffic. Tony Parker. And Jefferson with another rebound.
Terrific play by Levine there. I think the passing ability of Anderson becomes contagious on other people. There's no doubt that Steve Anderson's right on target about how they have to really make a commitment to defense.
Hood. And Adams with a rebound. Anderson on the bench right now for UCLA. Alford at the point. David Ware having a big night. His first miss of the game. And Parker, Tony Parker, he's lost a lot of weight, about 25 pounds since last year, draws the foul, and will head to the free throw line.
Good rebound right there by Parker. Came in recruited by Ben Holland. I hope Ben gets a big job next year. Some people be very wise to hire him. But you look at his total track record at UCLA. Yeah, there were some down moments, but let me tell you, man, three times to the Final Four. Then he had the one situation, he went to the final game, got beat by Florida, and also lost when he went to the semifinals that lost to Florida as well.
Dawkins in for Suleiman. I think it's a nice ovation for the Duke fans and from his teammates and coaches on the bench. Parker bricked that first attempt.
Yes, he did. 2008, they lost to Memphis. That's the year that Chavez hit that shot. Hey, what about LeBron last night? I love it. I love seeing players the old-fashioned way get a little upset if a teammate's a hustler. That doesn't mean that you don't like a guy. That means, hey, man, I love LeBron.
2-3 zone UCLA. Parker in the middle right now. He steps out, finds Dawkins, and you know what he's going to do. Misses the corner three. Another offensive rebound. Another miss.
You're going to get three opportunities.
Wow.
You can't give Duke three opportunities. They're not scrapping. That's the one negative of the zone. You don't have blocked out assignments. See, I don't think they're really a customer play the zone. That's not five guys moving as a unit.
Duke plus 7 on the glass. This is their 30th three-point attempt of the game. They had 3 looks from 3 on that trip.
See, what you're really doing is hoping they're going to miss their 3.
How about that rejection by Jefferson?
He's been a positive force here.
Has he ever?
Peter Jefferson rotating over defensively. Has the great angle for that block shot.
Suleiman back in for Dawkins. Jefferson really having an impact on this game.
You know, most guys have a great shot block with the left hand.
All for the drive. Parker underneath draws another foul.
You've seen some good passing by Alford, by Levine, certainly by Anderson, but you got to convert on the other end.
Emile Jefferson the foul, his second, as Josh Hairston gets ready to check in now for the Blue Devils, and Parker heads right back to the line for UCLA. Holiday Hoops presented by K Jewelers continues Saturday on ESPN at noon. The Georgetown Hoyas and the Kansas Jayhawks, a game you can also see live on Watch ESPN.
You know, Dan, we mentioned Ben Howland. Sometimes a divorce is healthy for everybody involved. I think that to the point that's even healthy for Ben. And I think in hiring a guy, I questioned a little bit about when Steve was hired because he had signed that long-term deal at New Mexico. But I'm telling you, I really believe he's the right guy. And I think that Steve is going to do a heck of a job when he gets his people. They're going to play exciting basketball, and they're going to play winning basketball. And you better be excited to get fans in the arena.
And there will be some big-time recruiting battles in the Pac-12. You would imagine now with Alford there and Andy Enfield at USC, and of course Sean Miller with a great program he's put together at Arizona, and there's so many talented players on the West Coast.
Look at the foul line area. Houston wants a flash right to that post area. Oh, they missed him. He was wide open.
Instead, the kick, the drive, the jumper for Suleiman. And UCLA can get it into single digits on this trip. And Alford will miss the runner.
And nobody back, no defensive balance. They're going to start to get minutes out of Suleiman. I can just see the bounce in his step. Nobody rotated back. And that's a no-no. Your guard goes to the goal. You're going to come back from the other side.
A travel to call on Adams.
Duke really playing well now in the last 4 minutes. So nobody back. Nobody rotates back. A simple layup for Suleiman. I could have made that layup. I may not have dunked it, but I could have made the layup.
You'd have been caught from behind.
You're probably right.
And you'd have missed the free throws. Anderson back in along with the Ware twins. Anderson potentially on his way to a triple-double, but UCLA down a dozen, just over 8 minutes to go.
Still got time. Starting to get dangerous. They're going to make some plays defensively. Now they rotate to the man-to-man, which has really been a dilemma for them.
Suleiman lost it. And then committed a foul.
Yeah, that's silly play right there.
Timeout on the floor. Duke and UCLA were tied at the half. The Blue Devils.
Mike Krzyzewski, we've documented so many times about his success, also internationally with the Olympic team. Let me tell you this. You think about John Wood, and I think in a pyramid of success. Dan, one of the great honors I ever received. I was the first recipient of a John Wood and Pyramid of Success Award. And I'm telling you, it meant so much to me because of the respect I have for him and the admiration of what he did in building his teams.
Steve Alford talks about it still being a little bit surreal to think of himself as holding the same job that John Wood had once held.
Well, he told me before the game, think about it. There I am at UCLA, John Wooden, a guy from Indiana, played at Martinsville High School where his dad ultimately coached Steve. And he said, I play for Robert Montgomery Knight, a legend beyond legends, an icon in my career. Doesn't get better than that.
You know, back to that graphic we showed about the consecutive weeks for Duke. In this day and age, because things are different now than they were back in the 60s and 70s, Anderson with the basket, to be ranked in the top 10 for six consecutive years, for 120 consecutive weeks, is remarkable.
Well, wait a minute now. I'm going to call you Dookie Dan now. So you're praising them. People don't get it. They just don't get it, man, and understand what it means when you talk about what they've achieved. It's most special.
Parker. And it'll be David Ware called for the foul.
Got to block out on that shot. You get a chance, an opportunity to come back and get it down to single digits.
And Duke is in the bonus.
That's the two areas of concern of Steve Alford: rebounding the basketball and defending. Scoring is not going to be a problem. Played on a team in 87 that beat Syracuse. Derek Coleman missing those free throws. Give it an opportunity for Keith Smart to shoot that baseline jumper.
Hairston misses the front end.
UCLA's got to start putting points up with possessions now, as Duke in the last 4 minutes will spread the court.
UCLA has scored only 16 points in the second half.
And that's really rare because that's one of their strengths. However, Duke's done a better job defensively. We've seen Duke improve defensively. We saw it in a Michigan game. I still firmly believe that Michigan will be a major factor in the Big Ten.
We got a game coming up this weekend with Stanford, I believe. Stanford coming off a big road win at UConn last week.
Yeah, but you got Johnny Dawkins. Yep. Talk about class. One of the classiest guys, played with our Jay Billis there in the mid-80s. Is the ball screen.
Parker now guarding Anderson.
Strength against finesse, made him kick it back out, stayed right in front of him. They let him beat him. He's looking for a screen.
Now the long jumper is true for Kyle Anderson.
He has really improved his shot. I mean, that was a real suspect last year, but he's playing with so much more confidence. He's got that little swag now, man. He's got that Jersey swag, just like Springsteen has. He's a Jersey guy, too.
Hood, they play on, and he knocks it down to restore the 10-point advantage.
I like him. I like him. He's a real Marco Polo superstar. I define Marco Polo guys that travel, transfer. Came from Mississippi State.
Averaging 19, he's got 14 so far tonight. Parker leads Duke with the 19. David Ware leads UCLA with 16. And his foul.
I mean, talking about tandems, not many tandems are going to produce like Parker and Hood. They go for 41 points a game. As Hood with the little left-hand jumper in the three-second area. And then there's Anderson. He said, come on, try and check me. Try and check me. That nice touch.
And another Duke foul. It's the third on Hood. And it's bonus now for UCLA.
Got to convert them to go to that line. Yeah, no, you're a proud daddy. Your son Matthew looks great in the house tonight. Sitting with my wife, Lorraine. Did he pay for those tickets?
You were my connection.
I tell you what, the perks of ESPN. You can't put a definition on it.
Alford knocks down the first.
You know, a lot of people questioned when he came to UCLA. Oh, just coming because of his dad. Let me tell you, he's legit. You know, told me that before today. Mike Krzyzewski said, I'm really concerned about when they go to the bench for Levine and Alford.
Let's go to Andy Katz.
Yeah, this is obviously a very unique situation for Steve Alford. He was coached by his father, Sam. You've got Bryce Alford rooming with his brother, Corey Alford. And Steve telling me that Bryce sacrificed a lot because he's changing his position. He was much more of a big-time scorer in high school. Now he's got to adjust, obviously, with Kyle Anderson playing the point.
And a pretty heady play there by Bryce. Not putting up the shot necessarily, but he saw he had Cook in a vulnerable position, and he just ran right into him to draw the foul.
This is a very key time now for UCLA to make a little spurt.
Here's the IQ of the coach's son.
Yeah, see right there.
Yeah, knew he had him at a disadvantage.
Cerebro.
It's Corey. Corey Alford, Bryce's brother.
Tommy loves the sunshine. Loves it in a Beverly Hills area.
And a critical miss by Alford. He's a very good shooter, although shoots the three great, but doesn't shoot free throws as well as you would expect, 63% on the season.
See the frustration in his face when he came back defensively.
Could have knocked it down to six.
Solomon gets some quality minutes. It's all about practice. You play hard in practice, you play the game.
Cook with a turnover.
Now, as soon as you spin and turn, the defense is going to rotate over.
Ware, nice look to Levine. Off the side of the backboard. Anderson, though, with a rebound. All right, UCLA missing some opportunities, Dick. This could be a six-point game, a four-point game. Things would have gone differently the last couple of trips.
Well, free throw lines hurt him as well.
Third on Adams.
Comes a four-point turnaround in sequence. Two you could add, now two the other way. Adams got a quiet 10. He's been one of the explosive scorers.
And Jabari Parker heading to the line for Duke. Scoreless in the last 8 minutes, but still a game-high 19 on the night.
Free throw line so big. You know, think about free throw line. I think in the ACC, North Carolina would be undefeated. They've lost three games close. Texas, they lost to UAB, they lost to Belmont. Do you know where they shot? I looked it up. 50 for 106 on the free throw line and three close losses. Yeah. Think about that. You can practice and practice, run your half-court offense. Hey, people, you got to make free throws if you want to win close games.
Timeout on the floor. 4:35 to go. The lead is back to 10 for Duke. Saturday night, ESPN2 stuffs your holiday hoop stocking with a doubleheader. It's Illinois into Missouri. That's always one of the most entertaining games, the Bragging Rights game where they split the building halfway between the Illini and the Tigers. And then the BlackRock Gotham Classic from right here at Madison Square Garden, Notre Dame and Ohio State. Aaron Kraft and the Buckeyes taking on a very experienced Irish team that's already been beaten, though, three times this year.
Sounds like a very sexy football matchup. Notre Dame and Ohio State. I mean, that sounds like a sexy football matchup. But Mike Gray's got some experience in the backcourt coming off the win over Indiana.
Kind of feels like a home game for Duke. They come here so often, and they bring all kinds of people with them. They fill up the Garden. There's some graduate students in the band, apparently.
I saw the grad.
Must be one of those fifth-year things where you get another year of eligibility.
I think he might have been there about 10 years.
Does UCLA have an answer? Do they have a run of them here in the last four and a half?
Look who's playing Anderson. Jefferson. Going size against him. And Cook on him earlier.
Parker helps out. Anderson just spins the other way and floats it in.
How big time does he look? Howard Garfinkel, super guarded, balled me when he was in high school. And said, let me tell you, this kid is as special as it gets. And we're starting to see the special ability he possesses.
And those numbers, 13, 10, and 7, that's not far off his season average. He's at about 13, 8, and 7 on the year. And there's a foul by David Ware.
And he goes at his own pace. He really does. He's like one step ahead of everyone, knows what he wants to do, seems to control the tempo. There he is right now. He's going to spin back. See, as soon as he spins, you should give help from the offside.
As Duke is leading UCLA 67-59, we mentioned earlier, Bruce's daughter Jessica goes to Duke, so he's been supporting the Blue Devils here tonight, and he has liked what he has seen here in the second half.
Well, I don't blame him. I think Mike Krzyzewski's liked what he's seen, too.
Parker at the line. He's got 20 or more points as he gets the bounce. Now in 9 of 11 games for the Blue Devils. Had 19 in another and 15 in another. He has been remarkably productive this year.
Came off a lot of injuries last year in high school. Hasn't slowed him down at all.
Less than 4 minutes to go, and Duke with a 10-point lead.
Amazing. Duke has taken 31 threes tonight.
Nice backdoor look, and Levine missed the slam.
Wow, he tried to bring the house down there on the reverse jam. They're really hurting themselves. They've had opportunity after opportunity to really close this gap.
Now Levine knocks it away, and he might get another opportunity.
There it is. Simple one. Very simplicity. Just lay it in the old-fashioned way. Right knee up in the air. Just drop it down.
Well, they missed the front end of some free throws, missed the layup, missed a dunk, and they're down by 8.
Gonna have to really tighten up defensively, though. Can't trade with them. Gotta come some stops. They're gonna learn to get more help defensively from the offside.
Suleiman in the game at a crunch time tonight for Duke.
See, it's one thing playing the ball tough, but you gotta have other people cooperate and play with. See, right there's an example.
What a play by Cook.
Nobody rotates over there. Nobody gives help. They are not playing good team defense.
A dozen now for Cook. The lead back to 10. Anderson over Parker for 2 more.
He really has. I tell you what. That's not the kid we saw last year, you and I, a couple years.
He's got the ball in his hands so much more this year, obviously, with the departure of Larry Drew II, and Anderson's in such a comfort zone this year.
Well, the ball should be in his hands. There's no doubt about it.
Duke taking the air out of the ball a little bit here.
See, they do this usually when you get down to this part of the game. Spread the court, get great spacing. Force almost the foul.
Nearly stolen. The 3. Yes!
He's back. He's back. Be a little productive. Oh, you can see. That's the first time I've seen that kid with some joy and some jubilation this year. Major factor last year. This year he has been a non-factor. Machine Suleiman.
his second three of the game, and it's a big one with less than 2 minutes to go.
Oh, the bench loves it. Look at Wojo. He loves it. There's a nice spin in the lane. Nobody comes over, gives any kind of help. Terrific play, laying it on the glass. Quinn Cook.
So Cook and Suleiman and Hood have all been good, but the guy who's been the best, and this has happened a lot this year for Duke, has been the freshman Jabari Parker.
Yeah, he's been the star of stars. No question. He's the solid goal. PDP. Look how he splits the defense. Brings the body right to the defense and changes to the left hand. They're going to watch him right here, squaring up, shooting the three. Now he's going to go to the corner. Catches it very simply, squares his body. Baseline jump shot.
In addition to the 22 points, he's got 9 rebounds, and he's got a season-high 5 assists in this game as well. And Rodney Hood, these two so often, the dynamic duo. They average 41 points a game of the season. They got 37 tonight.
Thunder and lightning, man. Thunder and lightning.
UCLA needs some quick scores. Adams forces it. Suleiman saves it. Good hustle by Suleiman.
Duke totally in control right now. Totally in control. Spread the court. Nice pass. Layup. Duke's on to the winning circle. No doubt. Second half, they have played excellent basketball. Mike Krzyzewski's going to be proud.
Travis Ware, no. Jefferson down with another rebound and a foul. What an impressive second half by the Blue Devils.
It's going to be really impressive in an ACC, watching the likes of Duke and Syracuse hook it up. That's going to be an interesting situation. And North Carolina, major factor. I'm telling you, if they just make free throws, people are going to really have to worry about that.
And UCLA, which was hoping to get into the rankings, hoping to get that first big signature win, looks like they'll fall short. And they will play Weber State, then they're home to Alabama next week before they begin conference play in early January against their rivals from USC.
Come on, people, go out and support them. You kids down there, you students at UCLA, come out and support them. It's embarrassing. 5,000 fans. I mean, that is embarrassing to the letters on that jersey. UCLA, they deserve better. Steve Alford deserves better. The kids deserve better. It compounds itself because then ultimately ends up, you don't think other schools use that in recruiting?
Anderson the drive. Got all the way to the rim and then turned it over.
He was looking to make the spectacular pass to the trail man.
And Cook won't force it. He'll use the clock. It's his friend right now.
He's got to play 35 minutes a night. You can see why. Yes, that's their, they're at their best when they get there to that spacing. They go to a 3-2 set.
Anderson, no. Suleiman ahead to a wide open Jefferson.
Jefferson deserves that, man. He's really been a factor. Jefferson and Suleiman, if they play like they're playing now, you're talking Duke, definitely top five. If those two guys start to contribute on a regular basis, the three are going to give them stability when you draw Cook, Parker, and Hoyt.
What a second half. Tied at 37 at the half, and Duke has outscored UCLA 43-26 as Levine didn't see Suleiman beside him. And it's out of bounds off a frustrated Zach Levine back to the Blue Devils. This second half, probably the best basketball Duke's played at any point this season.
I agree with you, Dan. Dan, happy holidays
you
to
too,
you
buddy.
And all the people.
See you in the new year, my man.
Can't say enough about you. A great partner, buddy. Wish all the out there the best. Have a great, healthy, happy holiday. Remember this, even families that are struggling, if you got your health, you're a billionaire.
Look at the jubilation on the faces of some of the Blue Devils. Dawkins, Suleiman, as they run away from UCLA here at Madison Square Garden and end up taking it 80-63. Parker with 23-10, Cook with 14-8 steals. Hood had 14, Jefferson had 11-7 rebounds, and Suleiman got off the bench, got into the game, and played well for Duke tonight as well. They go to 9-2, UCLA drops to 9-2. As the Blue Devils have a great second half and beat UCLA by 17. Andy Katz is on the court with the star of tonight's game, Jabari.